The owner of the building in Malate, Manila, where an alleged scam hub was raided by police late last month, slamming that operation. The lawyer of the management office of Century Tower claims the raiding team disabled the building's CCTV cameras and conducted unlawful arrests. Attorney Baby Arcega adds police only had a search warrant covering the 23rd floor of the building, but also made arrests in other floors. The lawyer also says the target of the operation was Vertex Digital Entertainment Technologies, which had vacated the building since the end of last year. Police arrested 75 individuals, including a number of foreign nationals, for their alleged involvement in cryptocurrency scams. More rainy days ahead, particularly in Luzon, as Tropical Storm Marce continues to move closer to the country. Pagasa weather forecaster Veronica Torres now joins us with an update. Veronica, over to you.
Good afternoon to you, Carmina, and all of our audience at PNC. As of 10 a.m. today, Tropical Cyclone Marce is at 775 kilometers east of Borongan City, Eastern Samar, with maximum sustained winds of 75 kilometers per hour near the center and gustiness up to 90 kilometers per hour. It's moving west-northwestward with a speed of 35 kilometers per hour. Currently, for Metro Manila and the whole country, we're still experiencing partly cloudy to cloudy skies condition. However, it may enhance the surge of northeasterly wind flow, which may occur within this week. And the trough of the tropical cyclone will bring rains over extreme northern Luzon and the eastern section of Luzon beginning today or on Tuesday. Also, a weather advisory may be issued over the next days as Marce moves closer towards northern Luzon. Currently, we don't have any signal raised over any parts of the country. However, signal number 1 may be hoisted over the portions of Cagayan by tomorrow. The highest tropical cyclone wind signal that may be hoisted during the occurrence of Marce is wind signal number 4. We also don't have any gale warning raised over any parts of the country, but rough seas over the seaboards of Batanes, Babuyan Islands, Ilocos Norte, and Ilocos Sur is possible. So mariners of small sea craft, including all types of motor bangkas, are advised not to venture out to the sea under this condition, especially if inexperienced or operating ill-equipped vessels. We're also expecting, or with regards to the track of Christine, it's possible to make landfall over extreme northern Luzon or mainland northern Luzon area. Rapid intensification is likely. And that's the latest from Pagasa Weather Forecasting Center. Veronica Torres reporting.
Thanks a lot, Veronica Torres, there joining us on the line. President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. leads the National Day of Mourning for victims of severe tropical storm Christine in Batangas. Our very own Pia Gutierrez now joins us on the line for that story. Pia, over to you.
Yes, Carmina, President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. on Monday assured that his administration is committed to strengthening its disaster risk reduction and response efforts to prevent the further loss of lives amid the worsening effects of climate change. The Philippine leader made the assurance as he led the distribution of government aid to storm-affected residents during the National Day of Mourning for victims of severe tropical storm Christine in the town of Talisay in Batangas. In his speech, the president said that government aims to prevent casualties during calamities and disasters, even as weather events continue to become more extreme due to climate change. The president directed the DOST to strengthen its warning system and ensure that communities are given timely warnings on approaching storms and typhoons, and the DILG and DOST to improve disaster communication with LGUs. He also ordered the NIA, the DOE, DNR, and the MWSS to implement the early and gradual release of water from dams ahead of approaching storms and typhoons to prevent flooding in downstream communities. He then directed the NDRRMC to review its disaster response strategies and ensure timely distribution of aid to affected communities. He also called on the DPWH to ensure that infrastructures are safe and resilient to disasters and other extreme weather events. This includes the strengthening of the slow protection design of roads and bridges to make these more adapted to climate change. The Office of the President, meanwhile, turned over 10 million pesos of aid to each of the affected Batangas local government units of Talisay, Agoncillo, Cuenca, Lemery, and Valete. The government also distributed 10,000 pesos in cash assistance to each of a number of selected farmers and fishermen in Batangas. They also gave out housing construction materials to families in Batangas whose homes were either damaged or destroyed by Christine. Prior to this, the president went to Barangay Sampaloc in Talisay Monday morning for the observation of the National Day of Mourning. A mass was held in the barangay to remember the fatality of Christine, attended by Marcos himself as well as by the affected residents. Let's listen to the president.
Batid namin na hindi madaling maibsan ang sakit na inyong pinagdadaanan. Ngunit umaasa kami na sa suportang handog namin ngayon, kayo ay makapagsimula muli. Layunin natin na hindi na maulit ang pagkawala ng buhay dahil sa kalamidad. Bukod sa paggunita, nawa ang araw na ito ay magsilbi na hudyat na pagkakaisa para sa mas matibay na mga infrastruktura at mga programang inuuna ang buhay at dignidad ng bawat Pilipino.
Fermina, after Talisay, the president proceeded to the town of Laurel in Batangas to inspect the damage brought by Christine and to continue the distribution of aid to other affected residents and LGUs. Fermina?
Thanks a lot. Pia Gutierrez there joining us on the line.